in the circuit shown in figure 2, determine V using Thevenin's theorem. So this is V, that is voltage we have to find across a current source of 5 amperes, which is our load. So first of all, we will denote our load, that is we'll keep A and B at its load terminals. So what does Thevenin's theorem state? So Thevenin's theorem states that any linear bilateral network, example like this, can be converted to a circuit which consists of single voltage source, namely VTH, and single in series with a single resistor, namely RTH or Thevenin's resistance, and this is Thevenin's voltage, connected to load, whatever given. In our case, the load is given as 5 amperes of current source is given. So we have to find the voltage across 5 amperes of current source. So first of all, and one more thing, this is known as Thevenin's equivalent circuit. So first of all, for making Thevenin's equivalent circuit, first we need to determine the values of VTH and the values of RTH, so that we can design a Thevenin's equivalent circuit and calculate the required voltage. So let us find VTH and RTH. First let us find RTH. So there are certain rules of finding the RTH. First step is to remove load, or in other words, I can say that open circuit the load, whatever given. So you can see that in our case, 5 ampere current source was our load. So I have opened the load. Now what we have to do? The second step is that all independent voltage sources present in the circuit should be short circuit, or all independent current sources in the circuit present should be open. So in this circuit we can find only one voltage source, that is of 9 volts, and this is plus and minus. So what we have to do? We need to short it. Short means we have to replace that with a wire, or replace the source with its internal impedance. So in case of voltage sources we need to short, in case of current sources we need to open. So let's short our 9 volts like this. The third and the final step is that to measure the equivalent resistance between A and B, or that is where we removed our load. Now we have to find the equivalent resistance, and this will be our RTH. So equivalent resistance means what? We have to convert, or we have to replace this with only one resistance between A and B. So first we need to see anything is there in series and parallel. We have to look from back. We generally look from back. We can see that 3 ohms and 3 ohms are connected in parallel. That is 3 and 3 ohms are connected like this. And this is 3 another. This is A and this is B. So these are in parallel. So in parallel, what will be R equivalent? R equivalent will be R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2 ohms. So this will be 3 into 3 divided by 3 plus 3, which will give us 1.5 ohms. Or I can say that whenever the same values of resistances are connected in parallel, we only need to halve them. So 3 by 2 is 1.5. So either you do this or you do this, you will get same result. So let's replace this by 1.5 ohm resistor like this. Now we can see that 1.5 ohms and 3 ohms are connected in series. So equivalent resistance in series will be R1 plus R2 ohms. So this will be 1.5 ohms plus 3 ohms, which will be 4.5 ohms. So replace this by only a single resistor of 4.5 ohms. So we have turned the whole circuit into a single resistor, and this is our equivalent circuit, or RTH is 4.5 ohms. Now let's find VTH. So VTH means Thevenin's voltage. In Thevenin's voltage also there are some rules to be followed. First step is to remove the load, as we did in RTH also. That is, we need to open circuit this like this. Now the second and the final step is measure or determine the voltage across A and B. That is, we need to find the voltage across A and B, that is VAB I can write, and this will be our Thevenin's voltage VTH. And in this step we no need to open or short any sources. Now we can notice one thing, that when we open circuit this, there is no meaning of this wire and this wire, no need of this resistance. Why? Because the current flowing here and here will be zero. Why? Because these two are not connected. These are open circuited, so current will not flow. So we can remove these wires. But we need to determine VTH, that is here. So how we'll do? So this voltage will be same which appears across this resistor, that is 3 ohm resistor. The same voltage VTH will appear across here. So this will be our VTH. So let's remove this like this. So this will be our VTH. The voltage across 3 ohm resistor will be our VTH. Or I can say that VTH will be what? V is equal to I into R. So the current whatever is flowing in the circuit, let it be I. So V is equal to I into R. I into what is the resistance? 3 ohms. So this will be our VTH volts. But we need to find the current first. To find VTH, first we need to find the current. So let's find current. You can take KVL also in this loop, or as this is a simple series circuit, I can directly take, we know that I is equal to V by R. So the total voltage here is, that is, total voltage is 9 volts, and resistances, that is, equivalent resistances are 3 and 3. How they are connected? In series. So in series means 3 plus 3, R1 plus R2. So 9 by 6, that is 1.5 amperes. Now VTH will be 1.5 into 3 ohms, that will be 4.5 volts. So we have determined our VTH and RTH. Now let's make Thevenin's equivalent circuit like this. This is our Thevenin's equivalent circuit, which consists of a single voltage source, that is, we found out to be 4.5 volts with a connected in series with a series single resistor, that is RTH of 4.5 ohms, we already calculated it, and connected to our load. Now what we have to find is, in the question he is telling us to find V. So V is across the current source, the voltage which appears across the current source. So let's write the KVL equation in this loop to find V. So I am taking like this, that is anti-clockwise direction. And as this is a series circuit, only one current flows in the circuit. It is already given to us 5 ampere. So 5 ampere is our current. Now what is KVL? KVL states that the algebraic sum of the voltages in a closed loop is equal to 0. So I will be taking second sign always. Wait, I haven't put the signs to resistors. So where current is entering, I am treating it as plus, and where current is leaving, I am treating it as minus. But remember that you do not disturb the signs of any voltage sources. Okay. Now let's write KVL equation. I will be taking always the second sign. So I am coming from here, that is going from here. Second sign is plus here. So plus, what is the voltage? V. So plus V. Second sign here is minus. And what is the voltage? 4.5 and 5 amperes we have. So what will be the voltage? I into R. I into R. And coming here, the second sign is minus. So minus. What is the voltage? 4.5 volts. Is equal to 0. As per KVL. So let's solve it. 5 minus 22.5 minus 4.5 is equal to 0. That is, V minus 27 is equal to 0, or V is equal to 27 volts. This is our answer. So we have determined the voltage V, that is 27 volts is our answer. Thank you.